that consists of our healthcare workers, hospital workers, clinics, paramedics. We have a lot of our firefighters were in there, our dentists, our pharmacists. So that group now has been widely vaccinated. Those medical workers that are still not attached maybe to a hospital or a clinic, they of course are still coming to get vaccinated. We're also seeing healthcare workers that perhaps were unsure that they wanted to be vaccinated early on and now are coming back and saying, you know what? It's safe, or I feel better about it, so I'd like to get vaccinated now. And so those are also a lot of the health workers we're now seeing are those that were a little bit delayed in the early process. And so that is a really good positive thing. I also want just to note that we have, from there, we moved on to our emergency services sector. So police officers, 911 dispatchers, they all started to get vaccinated just last week. And most importantly, we started over the weekend our 65 and over population. And so we will actually be running multiple sites in the city. So we already have the health department site, and that site will continue to see seniors 65 and over. And then we will have this kind of super site where we will see kind of everyone as their groups move forward and move along. Also want to note that this site, we are starting about 1,500 a day. And then of course, we're gonna ramp up as vaccine becomes available. And so the more vaccine the federal government sends us, the more vaccinations we're gonna do at the site. So we can add and have capacity to grow pretty quickly. And we're really hoping that that actually happens. I wanna also note some announcements and some changes today, which we are excited about. The first is, we know what our priorities are, right, with the groups. We're in that group B, that first part of B, and we're focused on those emergency responders, our 65 plus. But we are also beginning today, we are bringing in our food workers and supermarket workers. And so some of them have already received appointments, and others are now going to be integrated into now this site. And so that information is going to be put out by the city later today. But what we encourage is, if you are a grocery worker or you work at a supermarket, first and foremost, you should connect with your employer because they are connecting with the health department. And if you've not connected with your employer, we're going to show you how to sign up here in just a minute through our new vaccination system. But now we have expanded to also food workers, and these includes cooks in restaurants. Restaurants that are doing food, of course, out to the public, people that are working in supermarkets, in bodegas, folks that are handling food at distribution centers. So that is also a new group of worker that we are now beginning to vaccinate. But please know that we are full, and so we are, for these next few days, our appointments are full, and so we're just adding people in as we go and as appointments open up. And I also want to remind folks that we are excited that beginning next week, we begin vaccinating our education sector. And that begins by vaccinating our teachers and staff at Long Beach Unified School District. It will be, I believe, the first major school district to begin their mass vaccination. It's the third largest in the state. And we begin vaccinating Long Beach City College as well next week, and we'll be folding in Cal State Long Beach here hopefully soon as well. And so that is where we're at as far as vaccinations, and it's we are far ahead, of course, of many other agencies. I also now want to announce that we are today officially putting out our notification system, which is called VaxLB. So VaxLB is the new system where everyone now is going to be sent to. And essentially, you'll be able to go to VaxLB, and there'll be a link on the homepage, or it's longbeach.gov/VAXLB, but you'll be able to access it from the city website. And that is a system that you basically put your information in, and it will tell you when your turn is next. So you'll be able to get a text message or an email about when you're up to get vaccinated, and it'll help you go through the appointment process. So if you're currently a healthcare worker today, and you go on VaxLB, it will help you get an appointment. Let's say you're in group C, or you're part of the general public, or you're not sure when you're vaccinated, you can also go on today on VaxLB put your information in, and we will notify you when it's your turn. And we'll also send you regular updates. So that kind of anxiety that a lot of folks have about when is my turn, we've transitioned to that system just today. We tested it over the weekend, and we feel really good about it. We'll text you, we'll call you, we'll email you. It's a really, really great system. It's a one-stop shop. It's in English, Spanish, Khmer, and Tagalog. Also, want to let people know that if you have, in the last day or two, emailed us at the former system, which was the COVID-19 vaccine .gov system, we're still getting back to those emails, but I encourage you just to sign up on VaxLB, because we're now transitioning over to that new system. So that is also really good news, and it's going to help us kind of organize where we are. Want to also just remind folks that we continue to see seniors every day, and it's a big priority for us, and that's a real focus for us right now, is trying to get our seniors kind of in and out the door. Before I turn this over to Dr. Davis, I'm going to have our councilwoman, Cindy Allen, just come up and say hello and say just a brief, some brief remarks about where we're at, and then I'm going to have Dr. Davis come up.
Thank you, Mayor Garcia, for working with our state and our regional partners. I also want to thank Dr. Davis for your incredible leadership. It's so wonderful to have this vaccination center here at the Convention Center in the 2nd District. I also want to thank all the partners, the health department, police, fire, convention center, mayor's office, all the folks that are working hard to make this logistically possible. But before we begin the recovery process, we have to get people vaccinated. I've been vaccinated, it's safe, and I want to encourage everyone to get vaccinated. So go to VaxLB to get signed up. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Councilwoman Allen and Mayor Garcia. Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here with you to talk about a major milestone in our mission to vaccinate every eligible person in Long Beach to help protect against COVID-19. I know the past several months have been really tough on people. The pandemic has affected many in our community physically and emotionally. But today, as I stand before you and look out at our new mass vaccine clinic, I feel a real sense of hope. While we regularly run flu vaccine events for several years, and we're building on our experience doing mass vaccinations for the H1N1 in order to bring that to vaccinate people on this scale. And we're working hard to balance vaccine demand with availability, all while making sure we're taking an equitable approach. Today, I'm going to share with you what to expect when visiting a city-run vaccine clinic. First, to get the COVID-19 vaccine, you'll need to make an appointment. It's important that you don't share the appointment link with your family or friends. If someone makes an appointment when it's not their turn, it causes longer waits for those who are in line, and it takes appointments away from those whose turn it is, and they're turned away when they get there. We will turn away people who register before it's their turn, even if they were able to make an appointment. The more people follow the rules, the more quickly we get to everyone, and that's the goal. On your appointment day, please be prepared to spend some time waiting in line. Lines have been over an hour. Get plenty of rest the night before and remember to hydrate. As you approach the vaccine clinic, city staff will direct you. They'll also check your information to make sure you qualify in this round. Details about what to bring, depending on what category you're in, are available at longbeach.gov/VaxLB. So just to go over some vaccine safety and side effects, the vaccine itself is effective and safe. Some people have wondered how the vaccine could be developed so quickly. The type of vaccine developed for COVID-19 has been researched for several years in other infectious diseases. Because COVID-19 is so contagious and widespread, many of those who volunteered for clinical trials were actually exposed to the virus. And so with so many exposures, the trials took a shorter time to see if the vaccine worked. Both Pfizer and Moderna report that their vaccines show approximately 95% of efficacy at preventing both mild and severe symptoms of COVID-19. The vaccines are effective in preventing COVID-19 across all age groups, as well as all racial and ethnic groups. After you receive the vaccine, you might experience some soreness in your arm at the injection site. Some people also have muscle aches or fever, headaches, or feel really tired, or just a little bit like you have the flu or a little under the weather. Usually, if you're going to have symptoms, they will happen within the first few days after getting the vaccine. They'll be mild or moderate and won't last for more than 3 days. If you experience any of these side effects, that's just your immune system reacting to the vaccine and building antibodies. It's totally normal. The vaccine does not contain the coronavirus in any form, so it cannot give you COVID-19. If you have any questions about the vaccine, please ask your healthcare provider. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention have developed a program called V-Safe, V as in Victor, Safe, to follow up on how people are doing after getting a vaccination. V-Safe is a smartphone-based tool that uses text messaging and web surveys to provide personalized health check-ins after you receive a COVID-19 vaccination. So through V-Safe, you can quickly tell CDC if you have any side effects after getting the COVID-19 vaccine. Depending on your answers, someone from CDC may call to check on you and get more information. After you get a vaccine, you can do a search for V-Safe in order to sign up. Now to turn to testing. While we are focused today for good reason on vaccination, I want to remind people that we continue to fight COVID-19 on all fronts. The health department continues to monitor cases in the city and conduct contact tracing and outbreak investigations when necessary. We also continue to conduct nearly 5,000 COVID-19 tests every day, both at our city test sites and via our mobile testing units, which we bring to underserved areas of Long Beach. New cases are starting to level off, but they are still very high. While the rate of new infections are not yet where they need to be, we do see signs that we may be plateauing after 2 months of surging cases. But we are plateauing at a very high rate. And we continue to lose too many people to this virus every day. And I just want to remind people that having an underlying health condition puts you at greater risk for serious illness or dying from COVID. And these underlying health conditions are things many of us are living normal and productive lives with, such as high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, and smoking or vaping. So when you wear your face covering, practice physical distancing, and gather only with members of your own household, you're not only protecting yourself, but also saving the lives of your loved ones and your neighbors. Even as we continue to vaccinate people, we still need everyone to continue taking these precautions for probably at least the next several months, if not longer. By taking these important steps, as well as signing up at longbeach.gov/VaxLB so you can get the COVID-19 vaccine when it's your turn, you're helping us beat COVID-19. The past several months have tested our endurance, but now we're at what we hope is the last lap. And this is Long Beach. We are a big city, but we have the heart of a small town. I believe in our ability to meet this moment and to come away stronger than ever. Thank you. I'll turn it back over to Mayor Garcia. My name is Anissa Davis, A-N-I-S-S-A-D-A-V-I-S, City Health Officer for the City of Long Beach.
Are there any questions? Sure. So we have our health department's in conversation with the health department in LA County to see if we can do a partnership like we did for testing, where for testing we actually absorbed Signal Hill, Paramount, Lakewood, and did a lot of the testing for the region. So we've made the request that we would also like to do that for our neighbors, as long, of course, as we get the vaccine support as well. And so that is a conversation that's ongoing. In fact, I had a communication just earlier today with the county and with Supervisor Hahn, who's also supportive. It just makes complete sense for us to vaccinate Signal Hill, to help vaccinate Lakewood, to help vaccinate our neighbors in Paramount. And so we would like to do that because we have, I think, the organization structure to get it done. We just need the okay from LA County and the additional vaccines from them, and we'll roll them right into the program. Yeah, in fact, we have a waiting list program here at the city, and we have yet to waste throwaway vaccines, and so we are getting every vaccine that we have, we are getting it into an arm, and we have a waiting list program for every single clinic, and so that is being used so that people can get called in if need to. I think that, correct me if I'm wrong, Kevin, but I think people are automatically signed on to the wait list or have been. For each clinic, is that right? Dr. Davis, do you know this?
I know we have a proximity list, so I'd have to get this. So as far as, we definitely don't want to waste vaccine. We haven't up until this time. So we have a proximity list, which is basically people who are eligible, who live close and would be able to come down. And then we would contact them. So that's how it works.
Anyone else? Yeah, I mean, I think what we're doing, and in fact, I talked to our health department director about this last night. I think what we are trying to do is get vaccines out as fast as possible, and so we're doing a little less of the, planning out a certain amount per day over the next two weeks, and we are trying to as fast as we can get vaccines out through these clinics, and we do. I will just as a cautionary note, I think, it may be that we get to a point in the next few days where we run out of vaccine because we're going so fast. And I think running out of vaccine, to me, tells me that we're doing our job. And so we got to make sure that running out of vaccine is a good problem to have. And so I think our approach is we are probably being less cautious about setting aside a certain amount of vaccine every day for the next 3 or 4 weeks versus getting it out the door. Every vaccine we put out there is saving a life, I think, in our opinion. And of course, there is some planning involved here because we want to make people get their appointments. But it may be we get to a point where we run out of vaccine and we tell folks, you know what? We're out of vaccine. And so we're going to reschedule you as soon as it comes back in. But at least we'll have gotten it out the door. And that is something I think. In fact, I have encouraged in the calls I've had with other mayors and other health officials, I've encouraged us to move towards that system. I just think it's faster and it makes more sense. Any other questions? Okay, great. I think Kevin, I think we're going to do you're going to do some walking, right? Okay, thank you guys. Oh yeah. We're going to do the Spanish interpretation. Let me say, I know you want me to say one thing in Spanish, so I'll say one thing in Spanish and then we'll do the interpretation. Estamos acá en el Centro de Convención para la Ciudad de Long Beach y estamos abriendo este nuevo centro. Es bien importante, ahora vamos a tener acá personas que trabajan en los supermercados, que si tienen años 65 o más, próxima semana si eres un profesor o trabajas en una escuela, y también gente que está trabajando en las clínicas y profesiones médicas. So estamos bien felices que está abriendo esto hoy día y va a haber bastante gente, miles al día que van a venir a este lugar. Gracias.
little gust to go by. Buenos días, hoy es nuestro comunicado de prensa para el 19 de enero de 2021. Empecemos con datos generales. Hasta la fecha, 44,418 residentes de Long Beach han dado positivo por COVID-19. Y desafortunadamente, hemos perdido un total de 535 residentes de Long Beach a causa de COVID-19. Ahora voy a hablar sobre la nueva clínica de vacunación masiva. Somos afortunados que aquí en Long Beach, una gran ciudad del tamaño de Miami o Oakland, porque tenemos nuestro propio departamento de salud. Somos una de dos ciudades en el condado de Los Ángeles que corre su propio departamento de salud. El personal de nuestro departamento de salud está haciendo un trabajo increíble al implementar la vacuna COVID-19 y ahora estamos en la fase 1B. Hasta ayer se ha administrado más de 20,000 dosis de vacunas en Long Beach. Hemos sido muy efectivos en la administración de vacunas y ahora estamos aquí en el centro de convenciones donde nos permitirá expandirnos exponencialmente a medida que haya más vacunas disponibles. Hoy nuestra oficial de salud de la ciudad, la doctora Anissa Davis, nos acompañó y se unió con el alcalde García entusiasmados de hablar sobre el centro de vacunación administrado por nuestra ciudad de Long Beach en el Centro de Convenciones y Entretenimiento de Long Beach. Nuestro centro de vacunación en el Centro de Convenciones funcionará de 10 de la mañana a 6 de la tarde entre semana. Este sitio ampliará nuestra capacidad para vacunar a 1,500 personas por día y podrá ampliarse a medida que las vacunas estén disponibles. Continuamos enfocándonos en los trabajadores de la salud, los adultos mayores y los servicios de emergencia, pero pronto nos vamos a expandir a los empleados del sector de alimentos que trabajan o viven aquí en Long Beach. De ahí pasaremos al sector de educación la semana que viene y también al colegio de Long Beach. Estamos ampliando las oportunidades para que las personas se vacunen a medida que esa vacuna sea disponible. Cuanto más nos asignen, más rápido llegaremos a todos. Dicho esto, sabemos que aún no podemos satisfacer la demanda. Una pregunta que el público hace es ¿cuándo es mi turno de recibir la vacuna COVID-19? Y nos complace ahora anunciar que tenemos un sistema de notificación en línea llamado VaxLB. El sitio de web es longbeach.gov/VaxLB. Las personas pueden completar un formulario simple para recibir alertas por correo electrónico, mensaje de texto o llamada telefónica para recibir actualizaciones de vacunas y recibir una alerta personalizada que le informa cuándo será su turno. VaxLB es una ventanilla única de información sobre vacunas y está disponible en español. Las personas que se registran para recibir notificaciones también pueden recibirlos en su idioma. El portal VaxLB se llevará a la página de citas cuando haya nuevas citas disponibles y sea su turno. Hemos visto una gran demanda para la vacuna, pero publicaremos nuevos espacios para citas en este VaxLB. También el 18 de diciembre se administraron las primeras dosis de vacuna a los trabajadores de salud en nuestros hospitales locales. Desde entonces, se ha vacunado a más trabajadores esenciales y adultos mayores en Long Beach, entre ellos más trabajadores sanitarios, trabajadores de servicios médicos de emergencia como técnicos de emergencia médica y paramédicos. Se necesitan trabajadores de la ciudad para la respuesta ante una pandemia y los servicios de emergencia, como los empleados de preparación para desastres y el Centro de Comunicaciones de Emergencia, operados por los operadores del 911, empleados del Departamento de Policía, miembros del ayuntamiento y el personal del Centro de Operaciones de Emergencia de la ciudad también son vacunados. Si tiene 65 años o más y vive aquí en la ciudad de Long Beach, puede programar una cita para vacunarse. Las citas deben hacerse con anticipación. Puede programar una cita en línea o llamando al área 562-570-4636 o el correo electrónico a covid19vaccine@longbeach.gov, deletreado COVID19VACCINE@longbeach.gov. La demanda es grande y la respuesta puede tomar algunos días. Por favor, sean pacientes. Sí llegaremos a regresarle su llamada. Como mencioné anteriormente, la doctora Davis, oficial de la salud de la ciudad, nos acompañó y habló sobre algunas logísticas. Sabemos que los últimos meses han sido muy duros para la gente. La pandemia ha afectado a muchos de nuestra comunidad física y emocionalmente. La doctora Davis mencionó que estar frente a ustedes viendo nuestra nueva clínica de vacunación masiva, la más grande que hemos tenido, se siente una verdadera sensación de esperanza. Aunque realizamos eventos de vacunación contra la influenza regularmente, hemos aprendido también de las vacunas que se dieron para el H1N1 en el pasado y estamos trabajando arduamente para equilibrar la demanda de vacunas con la disponibilidad, mientras que nos aseguramos de que estemos adoptando un enfoque equitativo. Hoy voy a compartir con ustedes lo que puede esperar cuando visite una clínica de vacunas administrada por la ciudad. Primero, para recibir la vacuna COVID-19, debe programar una cita. Si es un trabajador del sector alimentario o trabaja en el sector de la salud, es posible que ya lo hayan contactado a través de su empleador. También puede utilizar VaxLB y reservar directamente a través de la ciudad. Es importante que no comparta el vínculo de la cita con ningún amigo o familiar. Si alguien hace una cita cuando no es su turno, provoca esperas más largas para aquellos que están en la fila. Quita citas para aquellos a quienes les toca su turno y se les rechazará cuando lleguen a esa cita. Rechazaremos a las personas que se registren antes de que sea su turno, incluso si pudieron programar esa cita. Mientras más personas sigan las reglas, más rápido llegaremos a todos y ese es el objeto. El día de su cita, esté preparado para pasar algún tiempo esperando en fila. Ahorita las líneas están durando aproximadamente una hora. Descanse mucho la noche anterior y recuerde hidratarse. Al acercarse a la clínica de vacunas, el personal de la ciudad lo dirigirá. También verificará su información para asegurarse de que califique en esta ronda. Los detalles sobre qué llevar según la categoría en la que se encuentre está disponible en el sitio de web longbeach.gov/VaxLB, deletreado V chica AXLB. La doctora Davis también habló sobre la seguridad de la vacuna y efectos secundarios. La vacuna en sí es eficaz y segura. Algunas personas se han preguntado cómo se pudo desarrollar la vacuna tan rápidamente. El tipo de vacuna desarrollada por COVID-19 lleva años en desarrollo para otros virus infecciosos. Debido a que COVID-19 es tan contagioso y se puede pegar a varias personas, muchos de los que se ofrecieron como voluntarios para los ensayos clínicos estuvieron expuestos ya al virus. Con tantas exposiciones, los ensayos tomaron menos tiempos para ver si la vacuna funcionaba. Tanto Pfizer como Moderna informan que sus vacunas muestran aproximadamente un 95% de eficaz para prevenir los síntomas leves y graves de COVID-19. Las vacunas son eficaces para prevenir el COVID-19 en todos los grupos de edad, así como todos los grupos raciales y étnicos. Después de recibir la vacuna, es posible que sienta algún dolor en el brazo en el lugar donde se le administró la inyección. Algunas personas también tienen dolores musculares o fiebre, dolor de cabeza o se sienten muy cansadas. simplemente se sienten con un poco de gripe. Por lo general, si va a tener síntomas, esos aparecerán dentro de los primeros días después de recibir esta vacuna. Serán leves o moderados y no duran más de 3 días. La vacuna no contiene el coronavirus en ninguna forma, por lo cual no puede darle el COVID-19. Si experimenta alguno de esos efectos secundarios, es solo su sistema inmunológico reaccionando a la vacuna y formando anticuerpos para protegerlo, y es totalmente normal. Si tiene alguna otra pregunta sobre la vacuna, puede hablar con su proveedor médico. Los Centros para el Control y la Prevención de Enfermedades, los CDC, han desarrollado un programa llamado V-Safe para dar seguimiento al estado de las personas después de recibir una vacuna. V-Safe es una herramienta basada en teléfonos inteligentes que utiliza mensajes de textos y encuestas web para brindar controles de salud personalizados después de recibir la vacuna COVID-19. A través de V-Safe puede informar rápidamente al CDC si tiene algún efecto secundario después de recibir la vacuna de COVID-19. Dependiendo de sus respuestas, alguien del CDC puede llamar para ver cómo está y obtener más información. Después de recibir una vacuna, puede hacer una búsqueda de V-Safe, S-A-F-E, para inscribirse. Aunque hoy estamos enfocados, y por muy buena razón, en la vacunación, quiero recordar a la gente que continuamos luchando contra COVID-19 en ambos frentes. El Departamento de Salud continúa monitoreando los casos en la ciudad y realiza el rastreo de contactos y las investigaciones de brotes cuando es necesario. También continuamos realizando casi 5,000 pruebas de COVID-19 todos los días, tanto en nuestros sitios de prueba de la ciudad como a través de nuestras unidades de pruebas móviles, quien lleva esas pruebas a las áreas más necesitadas aquí en la ciudad. Los casos nuevos están comenzando a estabilizarse, pero aún son muy altos. Aunque la tasa de nuevas infecciones aún no está donde debería estar, vemos señales de que podríamos estar estancado después de 2 meses de aumento de casos. Sin embargo, seguimos perdiendo personas a causa de este virus todos los días. Y solo queremos recordarles a las personas que tienen un problema de salud subyacente que lo pone en mayor riesgo de sufrir una enfermedad grave o morir a causa de este virus. Y estas afecciones de salud subyacentes son cosas con las que muchos de nosotros llevamos una vida normal y productiva, como la alta presión, diabetes, obesidad, tabaquismo o también vapeo. Cuando usted se cubre la cara, practica el distanciamiento físico y se reúne solo con miembros de su hogar, no solo se protege a sí mismo, sino a toda la comunidad. Incluso mientras seguimos vacunando a las personas, todavía necesitamos que todas sigan tomando precauciones, probablemente por los próximos meses. Al seguir estos pasos importantes, además de registrarse en longbeach.gov/VAXLB para que pueda recibir la vacuna COVID-19 cuando sea su turno, nos está ayudando a vencer a COVID-19. Los últimos meses han puesto a prueba nuestra resistencia, pero ahora estamos en lo que esperemos sea la última vuelta. Y esto es Long Beach. Somos una gran ciudad, pero tenemos el corazón de un pequeño pueblo. Creemos en nuestra capacidad para enfrentar este momento y salir más fuerte que nunca. Muchas gracias por acompañarnos. Esto es todo por hoy. If you have joined during our Spanish translation, please visit the city's Facebook page to view this press briefing from the beginning with Mayor Garcia and Dr. Davis. We thank you for joining us.